Before we begin, thank you very much to Ganon D for joining the Patreon campaign over at patreon.com/TJOmega. As I record this, I am literally $1 away. I'm not saying that to get someone to pitch in one more buck. I'm just saying, like, that's how close it is to making me review Beast Machines. If it gets to, if it gets to 600 and then we tick over the next month, then I'm doing it. So, thank you guys for the support. Seriously, it does mean the world to me, and it does legitimately keep the channel going. What does not keep the channel going, by the way, is Logitech brand webcams, because this is supposed to have another webcam, like here, like of my face, like I've been doing a lot lately, except my secondary cam here at home decided for some reason to default to something like 10 pixels wide to 100,000 pixels tall, and I can't fix it. So, no more Logitech. Let me recover from my vacation and then let me put on an eBay sale, and then we're going to put in more of these Keo Pros, which seem to be doing far, far better. But nevertheless, we march on. I wanted to share experiences with you on this channel like we did with the Ultra Zord a few videos ago. But this time it's going to be for this DinoZone DE-8 Shadowmammoth. For those not aware, DinoZone became DinoZaurs over here in America. It was a pretty cheaply done dub of a Japanese CGI / 2D animation show, which was pretty shamelessly trying to cash in on Beast Wars and Transformers in general by doing their own transforming beasts, not only copying the dinosaurs, which were frequent in Beast Wars, but also copying the transmetal look by making a lot of them chrome. It is definitely a different aesthetic, but you can also see where they are absolutely trying to get in on the popularity. I've never actually experienced one of these before, so let's give it a shot, shall we? Sunrise did the animation. Bandai, 1998, so you know the time frame we are dealing with. So there is kind of a theme to some of these. We see, we get our traditional little look through everything that the toy does. On the back of the box, a little bit of a bio I cannot read. What's more interesting to me is the centerpiece here, where it seems as though that there were two versions of every figure in this toy line. We have good guys, bad guys, at least as far as I can tell. And then smack dab in the middle is the dragon, the serpentine dragon, which I think is the only thing people really remember from this series. So this stuff, super good. I kind of want to get one of the T-Rexes someday. They definitely look like they're the best action figure one, especially the beast mode. You can see the articulation on the tail in that T-Rex. Yeah, at some point. But hey, I wanted to try one of these just to see what the toy line is like. It was $25. That's not a bad little thing to get a comparison on. Probably not going to find the T-Rex that cheap, but maybe someday. For now, let's open Death Eater Shadowmammoth. There's a name, Death Eater. All right. And once again, TJ desecrating a 24-year-old toy live on camera for your entertainment value. As you can see, some of my favorite things have been included. A lot of translucent plastic and a lot of 90s chrome. It's not the most comforting sight in the world. We have this, which is hinged, but it's very soft plastic. Very, very soft. So that's not the most encouraging thing. All right, let's get Shadowmammoth out. And whew, already it does not feel great in the hand. Set you down. Where is your instruction sheet? Please tell me you had one. All right. Yes, you do. Hang on. I mean, all in moon runes, but we really don't need any real guide here. I think we can pretty much figure this out, right? Yeah. So, not terribly complex. He's only got about 6 full-on transformation steps to him. That seems to be a guide on how to store the weapon inside of him. Or to have, like, some kind of weapon mode. Which I hate the kind of half-transformed weapon modes we've well established on this channel. So if that's what they're going for, we ain't doing it here. I kind of just want to see what this thing feels like. And who? Okay. Not great. Let's see if I can get him in the... See if I can shore him up a little bit. It doesn't seem like I can. The neck piece... You see that neck extend in there? There's no way to really, like, there's nothing else to plug that into. Let's see, if we, let me try and get his... I'm trying to get his beast knees in the right position. Big, chunky, translucent ball sockets, by the way. They're not terribly tight, so I don't think breaking is such an issue on those. God, look at this. Look at the wiggle. look at the wiggle. There's not a whole lot of just like solid feel in this toy. And not a whole lot, like, some things just don't feel right on this thing. Okay, so I've got a handle on one side of his head that doesn't seem like it does anything. Like, I'm looking around, it's like, is it gimmick activation? It doesn't seem like it. It doesn't tell me, nowhere on this instruction sheet does it actually point out that particular handle, trigger, whatever it is. In fact, the instructions seem to go out of its way not to show that side of the mammoth. Oh, okay, it went never mind. I see it. Yeah, so apparently moving that up and down is going to move the snout and the tusks. And can it actually do that? It actually hold on to the head to make that work. Okay. Oh. Oh yeah. In the most natural of movement for a mammoth, as it can now flex its tusks, as elephants and mammoths are known to do. And it's a little bit of gimmick in there. It's not bad. It's not hurting anything because it's just taking up that huge chunk head. All right. So how do I transform this thing? It's not terribly complex in the least. It's mostly just straightening things out. So let me like crack him open. Alright. That's mostly him done. He's just kind of exposed, he's airing out his armpits right now is what he's doing. So let me get these It already came right out of the ball socket. That's a great sign. Yeah, look. Ah, there we go. That didn't want to go back in for a second. All right. So, let's see if I can get the other shoulder working without anything popping out of it. Ah, this doesn't feel good, by the way. There's like a softness to it that really shouldn't be there on something that's supposed to be like a articulated joint. Also, oh, God, do you hear that crack in there? Also, head fell off. Head fell off of a... Oh, God. I didn't notice where this plugged in before. Hang on. I had to censor this. That's where it was. I'm sorry, YouTube. I'm sorry, it's just a toy. It's just a toy. I'm not doing anything bad. How are the arms supposed to look on this? Oh, they're posed weird on here. Of course I can't see. Alright, never mind. I'm gonna position them where he actually has what gives him the most movement. Alright, there goes the mammoth head again. Oh. Okay, you stay over there until I'm ready for you. There was something in the hips, I thought. The instructions looked like they did, like something was supposed to happen in the hips. Yeah, yeah. It's like there's extensions in there or something. Yeah, where it's like supposed to either hinge forward or outward. Okay, I see him. I see him. Yeah, it wants him outward for this mode, which I think he looks fine that way. Like, I think he looks like fine that way, but it wants him to be a little bit more squat. Because it really wants me to do that, which actually limits his articulation. There is a step in the transformation that limits the articulation. What are you doing, DinoZaurs? If that's even correct, because... I don't know. It's what it says. No. Oh, okay. 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 No. 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 I see. I see it. I see it. Okay. I was joking about the. I was joking about the instructions not helping, but they're really not helping. I think this is supposed to be. I don't know what this is supposed to be. There's just like a side note. Here's where I got confused. So there's the steps to straighten out the hips. The hips were already straightened out for starters. So I was looking at this one where it shows you how to put the hips back into position. I don't know, just it threw me off there for a second. Okay. So those hips actually do go in the position that where they work best. All right, all right. So yeah. Very, very extremely simple transformation now that I actually just like see the whole thing. You basically just open up the shell, raise the lower the arm, straighten out the mammoth head, and you're done. All right, fine. I have to put your trunk back. If I can actually... that unclipped. Can I actually fold it up the way it's supposed to? Nope, that unclipped. And now you just have a hinge. Yeah, it doesn't... That's weird. It doesn't mention anything about it unclipping or anything. It's just supposed to swing into place, but there isn't engineering for it. It's like, that's how it was. And then I hinge it up like this, and then that's as far as it goes. It can't quite reach his chest that way. It's like... Is this upside down? This might explain why some of the weirdness in the head's articulation in beast mode happened, if this is how it went. Yep, it was misassembled in the box. Okay, good to know. Good to know. All right. All right, so that... Okay. We're fumbling through it, but that is not a complex transformation at all. It definitely helps when... the instructions actually are... Well, the instructions probably are clear if I read Japanese. It would help if... It would help if it came correctly assembled, and it would help if it came correctly transformed. It did neither of those. Aesthetic-wise, I have to admit, it's not bad. Gunmetal and the gray and the red is not a bad color combination at all. I don't mind the head sculpt. Form-wise, it's fine outside of, like, he's carrying a massive amount of shell on his back that's not really designed to fold up in any way. And, of course, massive chest, which that's going to get in the way of posing. Let's see. He stands up fine. You can hear, like, little crunches as I manipulate these joints for the first time in over 20 years. I'm surprised he can actually, like, balance really well, considering his weight distribution's got to be all over the place. Ankle tilt. Holy crap. A 90s transformation toy that has ankle tilt. That's actually kind of impressive. Your head? Basic swivel. No ball joint. I will say... Not a lot of him feels great. All the ball joints feel really soft. Not like they're loose, but just like... I don't know. I don't know. Like, there's this, like... It's hard to describe. They're not loose. Well, they are. They're a little bit loose. But they just... they don't feel solid, if that makes any sense whatsoever. Articulation is weird in the arms. He can't, like, get his arms outward in any way. Yeah, that's, like, that's the best I can do there. And there's something about this, like, chromed head. Like, I don't know, you can't hear it. There's like a little bit of crunch where the chrome inside is kind of rubbing in the engineering. It's weird. I mean, the bone aesthetic is cool. I kind of like the bone aesthetic. And fair play to them. All the chrome is intact. No chipping whatsoever. I don't know. It just feels weird. Like, it's definitely not like Transformer quality. Especially like mid-90s. Where is a deluxe? Do I have a modern deluxe? Got a modern Voyager. How about that? So, there's your size comparison. He's a pretty beefy boy. Yeah. So, as a first experience into DinoZaurs / DinoZone, I probably could have found a better figure, to be sure. Like I said, the Tyrannos look like they would be better toys in general. When I went to Frankenson in L.A., well, outside of L.A., it's City of Industry, but there was a Transformer booth in the back that actually did have boxed DinoZaurs up top. Never bothered asking how much they were, because judging by the prices on the rest of his box stuff, yeah, it probably would have been out of my range. But I might keep my eye open and give this another shot. Like, I'm not thrilled with how the toy feels, but I do like how it looks. I feel like if I could find one that's more complicated, I might be a little bit more into it. And definitely one that could articulate in both modes better. I think that is going to be the Tyranno if I'm lucky enough to find. Also, like, why is this, like, crooked? Is that just, like, bent from being in the package for so long? Or just, like, something off? I don't know. But, yeah. DinoZone feels weird, man. That's about the long and short of it. But regardless, thank you guys for watching. Thank you for joining me on this random toy experience of mine. Stay tuned. We might have more along the way. I don't really know yet. I'm just kind of winging it. But hey, I'm having fun, and that's what toys are all about. Guys, I am facing the most powerful enemy any YouTuber can face, the algorithm, and I need your help to defeat him. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and leave a comment. Every time you do, we attack that algorithm and we drive it back until it can no longer defeat this channel. Thank you very much.